Now, as Courtney said, it is the story of much of corporate America. They're all talking about Hewlett-Packard's chief executive Mark Hurd and his resignation, this following a sexual harassment investigation. What can other companies learn from this? We're joined by two lawyers with a very thorough understanding of the workplace and the issues involved. Murray Schwartz, managing partner at Schwartz and Perry, has worked on several landmark sexual harassment cases, including Thornton versus Penthouse Magazine. Also, we have Lisa Banks, a partner at Katz, Marshall & Banks, focusing on sexual harassment and other workplace discrimination issues. And she was named one of the best lawyers in America for 2009 and 2010 by the Best Lawyers Referral Guide. Lisa joins us from Washington, D.C. Murray Schwartz, good to have you with us on Bloomberg. In hearing all of the reports on Mark Hurd's resignation from Hewlett-Packard, is there more than meets the eye? We don't have a lot of details. Is there something more going on, do you believe?
There must be, because it's difficult to understand how, with the little that we could read, the resignation took place and the amount of dollars that changed hands. And it just seems that there would have been something that occurred that would give us more insights, but it doesn't appear in any of the publications. So we're left to make decisions and judgments based upon what we read.
Now, when you mention money changing hands, this has to do with a potential $35 million severance package for Mark Hurd.
That's correct, which is a significant amount, which, by the way, as a plaintiff's employment lawyer, I was particularly upset about in the way in which it was done by the company. I think that didn't help women at all. I don't think any woman is better off for the decision, because it seems to imply that someone could be guilty of sexual harassment and end up with a parting package of $35 million.
Lisa Banks, you've heard what Murray Schwartz is saying. Do you think that there's more to the story that we're yet to learn?
I think there has to be. I think that the company's actions don't seem to make a lot of sense. If what they're telling us is true, in my experience, this is not the type of thing that would lead to the ouster of the CEO.
Why would the CEO resign in a case where it has to do with expenses and apparently filed expenses that were not accurate, when indeed there are no charges being brought having to do with sexual harassment? Lisa Banks?
Well, I guess that's the question. The company has said that their investigation didn't find any evidence of sexual harassment. He, of course, has denied it. The company is hanging their hat on these expense reports, but even if the expense report issue is true, it doesn't seem to make any sense that they would push out their CEO, who had been so very successful for them, based on what is a relatively minor issue.
Murray Schwartz, this issue has to do with a complaint, a letter that was sent by the lawyer for Jody Fisher. This is the woman who has admitted being involved in the situation with Mark Hurd. Is that typical, where a board of directors would deal with a letter directly from a lawyer representing someone, but that would not be the catalyst for the ouster of the executive?
They would read the letter. They would listen to the letter. The articles went on to point out that there was an investigation conducted, and because the letter came in more than a month ago. Nowhere is there an indication of who was investigated, who spoke, and what they had to say. So I think that at this moment, all we're left with is what we could read in the paper, which was that he acknowledged that they had a relationship and they terminated him or asked for his resignation at that point. The business of asking for his resignation was also something that was upsetting. Normally, a lawyer would want to see justice meted out, and to give someone a pass and to let them resign in light of which what apparently happened and what must have happened for them to have terminated a man, you know, from a position as high as that with his background with the company, one has to be very, very, very troubled.